Thank you very much. So, good evening. I'm your deliverance. I'm the last speaker. Soon it will be over. And I hope that it will not be very boring and I will wake even those who are sleeping right now. First of all, let me thank for this kind invitation, because I'm very moved by the quality of discussion of those 2 days, because I spent 25 years working for the Foreign Service, and my 3 last years I spent at the United Nations in New York, talking every day about many different aspects of life between the entire whole world, all the states there sitting in one place, and we discuss life and norms. So, and what I see here, and it makes really me be very glad and say that we are privileged, because there's still countries who can sit, discuss, and be open about the problems that we have. As long as we have a discussion, the world is going forward, not backwards. Because when we, like I saw the invitation, it was invitation about the event Europe, in Europe, I have right away the tendency thinking, because in Italy, so most probably we'll talk about the European Union, because still European Union is a defender of the norms. When you take the audience of entire world, there are so many countries, and you see in the media every single day, there are so many countries who want to take us back, not to take us forward. So look, we agreed on the universal human rights. We agreed on what is democracy. We agreed what is rule of law. And every single day, what we do at the United Nations, we defend these norms. I mean, the countries of the European Union. And even inside of the European Union, we discussed also yesterday and today, so we saw that there are also tendency to take us back and take away from those norms. And that is very dangerous situation right now. Because we see like the cases like Hungary, for instance, because it's really, they are challenging, or Poland, they're challenging the very substance of the basis on what is created European Union. I'm Lithuanian, so we joined just recently. So for me, as a Lithuanian, is something that is always was some sanctuary where you can really go and you know that you are between the same kind people who will defend the norms. But we live in the world, as they say, more and more countries are taking us back. Even if you look at the US, what is happening, right? So the things, they were unthinkable in the sense of values, now is possible. So, and that is the introduction to say how much I really enjoyed this discussion yesterday and today. Because as long as we have the discussion, we still live in a privileged world. But if you take the countries who don't have this, and coming back to discussion about the religious freedom, I want to touch about the, like we discussed quite extensively about the situation in Russia, for instance, how things are changing, how there is no discussion. You cannot discuss about the liberty or the freedom or respect of human rights. There are norms, there is a narrative, clear narrative, and you just keep repeat, just say this, because you cannot go out of the box, of this small box. It's always only one truth and there is nothing else. Here we discuss the things and it's fun. I'm really enjoying it. So, and as I said, the European Union is still defending this freedom. And when we see some deficiencies and some risks, so it's very important that that there are scholars, there are media, there are NGOs as well involved in this discussion. Because the, here is difficult to preach for the converted, right? Because all of us, we believe in those things. It's more difficult to reach those who are, who have a different opinion. But we somehow, we need to do so. But again, I want to touch, come back to my thought about the countries who don't have this privilege of expressing themselves the way they intend to. And here there is a very delicate, and lately, I believe, because I was out of Europe for a few years, but it's quite painful aspect is the refugees. What we do with the people who flee their countries because they are persecuted, even tortured in their countries because they believe something else, not the, not something that the government is deciding or parties deciding that they should believe. So when the situation is still also is like the, is the same, is like different countries, even in the European Union, which is the advocate of the human rights, is still the situation is not the same in every single country. So when we, I'm quite familiar with one specific case, is the Church of Almighty God, is the Christian new religion in China, which is declared by the China's government as sect, which should be persecuted. And there are quite enough of evidence of the cases that people are really persecuted and tortured, because the torture is already, is really the red line. And the problem is that for them, in this, most probably, the double problem, in one, on one hand, the problem is that certain countries, they are very concerned about the sects or new religions movements. So they're very suspicious in giving the refugee status for those people. And on the other hand, is this overwhelming, huge, complicated problem of refugees. It is so complex, it's so big, and in fact, only European Union who is really dealing with this problem, if you look at the world's level, right? So the countries who even like, say, like Syria, war is Syria, right? They are very much involved in the problem, and they are not taking the refugees, but Europe does. So, or the separation between the refugees and migrants is still is a huge gray, a lot of gray zones that we can be very difficult for us to really see the truth. But still, because usually the European Union is always very, it's really the biggest advocate, I believe, for the for people, protecting people. Because when we talk about some refugees on the religious grounds, it's not only the freedom to express themselves, but in the case of the Church of Almighty God, is the question of protection, of physical protection of people. And the sad part is that just a few days ago, in France, some people, they were arrested, put in jail, and they will be given to Chinese government. And Chinese, certainly they will do only one thing, they will send people back to China. And once they will be back to China, they will be put in jail, they will be tortured, and we don't know, they will survive or not. Re-education is still a very mild aspect of the problem. The biggest problem, and we really have a substantial information that we can rely on, that that people very often, they are really physically tortured and even maybe killed. But myself being a bureaucrat for 25 years, so I know how the bureaucracy is working. And one of the arguments, for instance, in some countries is that people, they don't have the documents. But when you flee totalitarian regime, when you flee the really physical persecution and torture, very often you don't have the documents. So it's, so the problem is very serious. Is in this context of the refugees and migration crisis that we like to say that is a crisis. So we still somehow, and I don't know exactly how, we should help people to be seen. It's a moral responsibility and it's legal responsibility as well, but it's moral as well, to protect people who really they risk to lose their lives. And I was like thinking, is perhaps I'm still optimistic, and I think that if somehow these people might better prepare their case to defend themselves, perhaps they will succeed. But still, I believe that in Europe, in European Union countries, still the rule of law, that is the highest virtue. And I believe in that. It still is not only the political reasons, because the adversary, China, is very difficult adversary. It's very difficult to resist politically for the state. So, but I still believe that the problems that these people are facing right now, it's just the legal preparation, defense, and etc. And it's not really politically motivated. But at the same time, yes, we have the political interests between the states. And sometimes we, at the government's level, we sell certain things for the economical benefit. So that is the as I was thinking, the glass full, half full or half empty. And I believe that's the situation in general that is half empty and half full. But the meetings like this one, it's exactly something that we make this half full. As much as we continue understanding each other, have a dialogue, and reach out for those who are less believers than we are in the norms and rule of law, human rights, and etc. So we might be even more successful. Thank you.